Hey guys, I'm Voilin, and in today's video I would like to talk about the timeline for GoZen because we are getting closer and closer to the first alpha, and this camera is kind of heavy, so I'll put it down now. So this is my road map. I'm a dad, I'm allowed to make jokes like that. And here's my actual roadmap. As you can see, I finished a couple of things already from it. The FFM pack stuff is mostly done, except for the audio rendering. We have the start menu, which is finished. We have the main window that is finished, the project manager, the editor layout, the settings manager. All those things are finished. So what do we still need to get a first alpha version that people can use to actually edit videos with? Well, first of all, the settings menu and the project settings menu. I'm supposed to start this on the 18th. I've already started it because I've been running ahead of schedule. Which does not mean that the alpha will come any sooner. I may be too busy around New Year and not finish certain parts or like get behind schedule. So this is just a guideline. Let me make that very, very clear. This is just a guideline for the alpha of version 1. So yeah, the settings menu, the project settings menu. After that, I'll start to work on the media pool, and the media pool will basically be the place where you import your files and where you can see all your files, plus your global files. Because except for like your project specific files, you'll also be able to have files that are linked to the editor itself. So files that you regularly use in all your different projects, you'll be very easy, like it will be very easy to catch them from any project that you want to. And after that comes the timeline, which will require kind of a lot of time. I give myself 3 weeks. I'll probably need a little bit more time than that. I got some of the things figured out already of how I will do it. But yeah, far from every problem that I have with the timeline has been solved on paper in my head. Yeah. So that's will require a little bit more time. And the reason why project view is overlapping the timeline one, the timeline part, is basically, well, yeah, they kind of need each other to work properly, so yeah. After that, I give myself 2 weeks for the project view, just in case. Then I have the rendering menu that I need to make so people can actually render what's given in the timeline. And from that moment, normally you'll be able to edit videos. I won't call that alpha, like alpha yet, because I also want to implement some very, very simple effects. And also a transition. I also need to work a little bit on a file dialog system to import files. Will require a little bit more work. A bug report with Google Forms, just because it's easy to set up. I won't have to look at it, and I will get the mails the moment that people have found a bug and reported it for the people who don't want to use GitHub for bug reporting. And then the comment bar. Starting from here, after the bug reporting is on, I think I would release the alpha version. Because the comment bar, it's not really needed to work for the actual alpha. And the startup improvements are also just small changes that I have. So removing quick options for creating projects and switches out by like a mini menu so people can easily start new, create new projects from the startup menu. Check if opened with a path as an argument, because right now the startup, let's show this because this is something that I haven't really talked about yet. So the editor, the settings menu, and the startup, they're all separate Godot applications. And that's for a couple of different reasons, but basically it creates a little bit more structure and it also increases the performance, not by a lot, but by a small amount, which may help for larger working on larger projects. But if you start up the editor, you need to specify a project file. If people make the mistake by opening a project file with a startup menu, that it would still send that data and open the editor instead. Still a lot of things to work on. But that's just a small startup improvement. It's not really necessary. And have a separated line under the 5 most recent projects, because let's quickly open the startup. So this is the startup screen of GoZen right now. Over here, you will see your first, most recent projects, your 5 most recent projects. If you work on a lot of projects at once, that may get annoying that you can only see the first 5. So I'll add a little option that you can see all your recent projects. Also, you may have noticed like this is its own little window with rounded corners. There are some performance issues with that, and that's also one of the reasons why this is a separate project. I think this is possible to do through the desktop environment or the operating system itself to get the rounded corners. For now, I'm doing this through Godot itself by just using a mask and by having a transparent background, which is bad for performance. And if you take a look at the settings menu, you'll see why. So this is the settings menu right now, and you can resize it, but it has a very glitchy effect. This may be because of my window manager, this may be because of my operating system. I have no idea. I know that it has to do with my frame rate, because if I disable VSync, this becomes a lot smoother. It gets a little better, not too much, but yeah, there is a small difference. But that's basically the roadmap that I have for GoZen at the moment. I just quickly wanted to make this video to keep everybody a little bit more up to date. A quick note as well, starting from next week, I'll be uploading the videos related to GD extensions, to like how to create a GD extension, how to implement FFmpeg pack, how do you import videos into GoZen, how do you import videos with any type of codec into Godot with FFmpeg pack. And after that, I'll make another GD extension video about exporting videos, like rendering video frames from GoZen and from Godot to an actual video file. So that's coming up next. I'll try to get into weekly videos. My kid has been sick for the past couple of days. Some other unfortunate things happened in my life. So the last couple of days I've been too busy, did not really have time or the energy or the mood or the motivation to make videos. It's slowly starting to solve itself. My kid is now sick, sadly enough, but it's not too bad. So yeah, I'll slowly get into weekly videos. Also, for the people who have not joined the Discord server yet, if you want to stay more up to date with GoZen specific news, go to the Discord channel, select that you want to see the GoZen related stuff. And every now and then I'll post feedback, rounds, polls on GoZen specific things. For example, one of the recent polls as well that I did was about the editor layouts. And starting this month, every single week, I'll post a progress update about how the entire week went, what I was able to achieve, and what I'm working on next. So if you really want to stay up to date with GoZen related stuff, please join the Discord server. If you really, really want to support this project, please go over to my Ko-fi page. A big thank you to all the people who have been supporting me on Ko-fi. And I'll see you all in my next video. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye bye.